headed to the pyramid. She's working at the pyramid tonight. Working at the pyramid. Working at the pyramid.
Hey. Long time no see. At this point, every time I say I'm gonna be more consistent, it never happens. So am I gonna say I'm gonna be more consistent? Absolutely not. Cause it's just like, you get what you get and you don't get upset when it comes to me. Cause it's just like, I can't, like I cannot be consistent when it comes to YouTube. I am so sorry, please. But as you can see from the title, today I am doing an updated sneaker haul. I haven't done one of these in actually so long and I'm just so excited to show you what I have in store in my noise cue closets. If you hear outside noise, you obviously hear it because the window was open so I can have some breeze. You might be like, oh, new dewy makeup. No, this is sweat. I actually contemplated if I wanted to even make this video by taking all these shoes out of my closet, by going up and down my closet to get all these sneakers. Yeah, so hopefully you enjoy the video. The haul is coming next. Okay, so before I get to all my shoes for real, you guys are probably wondering what shoe do I absolutely wear the most all the time. To be completely honest, my pink Crocs. I wear these all day, all the time. Even if I'm not wearing pink, these are on my feet. Do I know why I have all these shoes just to put pink Crocs on? No. Am I ashamed? Absolutely not. So the first thing I'm going to show you is my Uggs, my cute Uggies. So the first Ugg of the show and tell is these. They're like boots with the two bows in the back. These were the It Girl Uggs. Like, if you had the bows in the back, you was that one. So the next Uggs I have are these red Numels. I really don't really wear these anymore because just like when it comes to an all red shoe, you can't, like me personally, I can't just put an all red shoe on. Okay, so now next I have the chestnut Tasmans. I don't know why the suede of the Uggs are looking atrocious and actually completely insane on camera, because it's kind of scaring me how it's scaring you. I need to just brush them because I honestly don't know what happened here. Next Tasmans I have are the black Tasmans. These are so cute. I actually really took care of these. I actually brushed these the other day so they could look clean and new. Guys, the next shoe I'm about to show you is actually insane. These are my favorite Uggs by far, and they are the mustard seed Tasmans. The way nobody can really get their hands on these anymore is actually insane, and I love that for me. Next boot I have of Uggs. Yeah, the suede is actually petrifying. Why is it looking like that on camera? I have no idea. We're gonna ignore it, but I need to brush all my Uggs. But these are my other Uggs. These, I actually don't know the name of them, but they're a cute and simple Ugg. No bows, just minimalistic and cute. Next Ugg I have are the Ultra Minis. Guys, I'm gonna give y'all a tip of how I got my mustard seed and these. I got my Uggs during the summer, because TikTok never fails but to hype Uggs when it starts to break, when the weather starts to break. And that's when all the girly pops remember to buy Uggs because it's getting cold, but they're all sold out on all back order. Now we are in the fluff, yeah, slide Uggs. I got them in red. These are cute. Last Uggs I have are the black fluff, yeah, slides. These are actually a size 5 and these fit me way better than the red ones, and these are very cute. I usually wear these during the summer because they are open toe, and yeah, I'm going to show you one of my pairs of Uggs that I actually love.
I clearly meant to say Crocs. I don't know what happened. I don't know what I was thinking.
Okay, and it's these. I don't know how to pronounce it, but y'all know what I'm talking about. So now I'm going to go into Vans. I only have two pairs of Vans because I got rid of a lot of mine. I used to actually be a Van girly back in like 9th grade, but I have these blue and white checkerboard slip-ons. I don't really wear these because these are not an easy color just to put like to match with. I'm about to show you, I actually like, it was a collab with Santa Cruz. My favorite part of the shoe is the inside because it has that, but they're just some tie-dye old school Uggs.
I meant to say Vans. I have no idea why I keep saying Uggs.
So now we're gonna get into Yeezys. The first Yeezys I'm about to show you are these. I forget if these are 500s or 700s. I don't know. I got these from StockX And I did get a used pair because I'm not about to pay $300 for shoes. So the used pair came in no box. Okay, we're moving on to 350s. I have these right here. I do not remember the name of these, but these are the ones that if you go outside, they turn pink. As you can tell, pink is my favorite color of all time. So these were so cute. They're like a bone color, but I actually love these shoes. Next, I have the Yeezy Carbons. These are my first pair of Yeezys that I've ever gotten. They're okay. They're nothing really like, nothing's really too crazy about them. They're just some black and gray and like a tan Yeezy. Okay, these are my favorite Yeezys of all time. My friend Natalie gave this to me. These are the Yeezy Breads. These are amazing. I actually love these. Like, by far, these are the best Yeezys in my collection. The next 350 are the Yeezy Belugas. I actually love the Beluga 2.0s, I think, because these aren't the original ones. These were like the second ones that came out. These are amazing. I actually love the pop of orange with the gray. Okay, I have one pair of foam runners, and they're the Orchard. I wear these actually a lot during the winter and fall with some like socks or whatever, because these are really cute. These are a size 6 and men, and they're very cute. I only have one pair of Yeezy slides, and these are like the chocolate ones. I forget the actual colorway name. My friend Natalie got these for me as well. She's amazing for that. Okay, so next we're gonna go on to Nikes. The first Nikes I'm gonna show y'all are my 97s. These are my favorite 97s by far. They were like the LA collection. When these released, I was actually super hyped because I love like an orange shoe. Like, to have an orange shoe in your collection is just fire. The next one I have are these. They're reflective. You could kind of tell that they're reflective on camera. They remind me of like sunshine and like the sky and clouds or whatever. I don't really wear these anymore. They're just not my type of style, like of colors anymore. But the next shoe, these are 270 Reacts. I actually love the colorway of these. I don't think I ever worn these yet. Cause I don't know what to really pair this with. I mean, I could wear like all black and just have like a pop of color with the shoes, but these are actually fire. I love the colorway of like the pop of color and everything. These are fire. These are Nike React Visions. These are like just some like running shoes or like shoes I used to just lounge in. I would just have these shoes on because they're actually really comfortable and light. So if you're on your feet all the time, I recommend these shoes for you because they're actually really comfortable. Okay, next are my Foamposites, the all black Foamposites. These are my favorites. These are my only Foamposites I have, and these are like the main ones that I actually like. Cause like you can never go wrong with the all black shoe. They are uncomfortable. Like you cannot wear these for a very long time cause it feels like you're standing on bricks and Legos. But these are actually like hard, like these are fire. All right, so next we got obviously white Air Force Ones. In my opinion, if you don't got no forces in your collection is not complete. Like you need some forces in your life because it's like a really simple shoe, but forces can literally go with anything. Mine are still crispy. All right, next we got some Flyknits. These, they a little beat up, but oh yeah, they a little beat up, that's insane. But they remind me of like snow because like the silver metallic and the white. I actually forgot I had these shoes until right now. Like you see they're like sparkly at the like with the bubbles. These are a vibe. So next we're on to the Dunkies. The first Dunks I have are these like cream colorway. These are a woman's Dunk shoe. I don't remember the exact colorway name, but they're like the recycled one because it's just like you see how it has like the gray and like the specs on the bottom, and it has like the neon green insole. But these are just a nice cute neutral Dunk shoe. The next Dunks I have are these. My boyfriend gave these to me. He devoured when he got these for my birthday because I love pink. These are the pink corduroy Dunks. I didn't wear them yet, as you can see, because I still had this on. Like having this on the shoe is actually insane. But yeah, no, these are actually amazing. I love these Dunks a lot because I'm a pink girly, and just having a pink shoe in my collection is actually amazing. And these are the perfect shade of pink. Tone it down, but you get the gist. They're cute, they're amazing, they're living, they're thriving. So next I'm moving on to Converses and New Balances. So the first Converse I'm showing is the white high top Converse. You can't really go wrong with these. They're a nice simple shoe. Next Converse I have are the black and white high top platforms. These are my only These are my only platform shoes. They make me taller. I am 4'11", so maybe I should probably have more platform shoes to make my height go a little bit up there, but I really don't care. But breezing through the shoes, because I still didn't get to all my Jordans. That's the longest part of the video, was the Jordans. So that's why I'm so like quick with it, because these are, you like filming? But next we got the CDGs, right? Yeah, CDGs. These are fire. I actually wear these are my most worn Converses, because this is cute, the heart and everything, like the black and the cream. These are a vibe. I actually love these. The price was actually insane. I think these were $150 for some Converses. It's actually crazy and scary. The next I have are the Bricks and Wood New Balances. These are my favorite. I think these are the 950s New Balance style. I really like it because it has the fuzzy laces and like the cream and the gray. All right, next are the New Balances, the gray 990s. These are a vibe. I actually love these a lot. A lot of people think New Balances are like grandma grandpa shoes, but these, I don't know, New Balance is actually stepping up the game. Next shoe I got are some Mijadas. These are fire. They're like Converses, like, but with the super chunky laces. I actually love these shoes a lot. They're super cute and simple. All right, so now we're on to Jordans. I'm gonna try to go by like number. I'm gonna go by like 1, 3s, 4s, 5s, you know. I'm gonna try. I might forget some. So the first, that was my bird, y'all. She wanted to do her little show. I had the Shadow 2.0s. They're a nice gray and black. All right, next, these are the satin snakeskins. These were like, my mom actually got these for me for my birthday a couple years back. You see how it has like the satin tongue. These are fire. I like the snakeskin material and everything, because like I just needed a black and red like Jordan 1 shoe in my collection. These are the UNC ones. I have like, I think I only wore these like once or twice since I've ever got them. I don't know why I don't wear them. Like, they're just amazing. They're like the one with the suede, with the white laces, is actually fire. I need to start incorporating these in my like rotation more. But next, these are my favorite ones I got. These are the Air Jordan 1 Mochas. Very hyped up shoe. Little story time. I actually wasn't gonna get these, because this was like before I was into like the brown and like in brown shoes and like clothing and like neutral colors. But then I was like, you know what, I'm gonna just get it for the hype, like, feel me, like, I'm gonna just get it. And I got it, and now I actually love these shoes, because they really go with anything, because like the white and black toe. And next I have is the Shattered Backboard ones. These are my first ever, like, these are like my first pair of Jordan ones I've ever gotten. The laces are a little messed up, but just ignore that. I actually like these shoes a lot. I don't really wear them as much, because I don't really wear orange a lot, but these are fire. They're very unique with like the material and like the patent leather and whatever. And now we're on to the Jordan 3s. I only have one pair of 3s, and these I think these are the Valentine's Day ones. Don't quote me on it, for I've been forgetting some of the names, but they're like the fire red 3s. I think that's what they're called. I actually don't know, you could look it up. But I'd actually got these, like, I was watching a video on YouTube one day and I saw these, and I'm like, I need to up my collection. I went on Foot Locker, they had my size in a size 5.5, so I was just like, I'm just get them just because they're a very popular shoe. I think almost everyone has these, but they're cool. They're like, okay, I don't really wear them anymore. Okay, now we're on to Jordan 4s. The first Jordans I'm about to show you, these are actually my favorite Jordans of all time, the Jordan 4 Breads. They a little beat. I actually got these for retail. Almost all my shoes, like my Jordans, I actually got for retail, except for some of the ones like my Shattered Backboards and my satin snakeskins. Those was resale, but all my Jordans are actually retail, because I was on the sneakerhead wave. Worked at a shoe store as well, so that's like one of the major things. But these are the fire red 4s. Very cute. I actually love these 4s a lot. These are like my second favorite 4s that I have, other than the Breads. All right, next, these are like the Oreo 4s, I think, because it's like they look like cookies and cream or something. I think they're the Oreo 4s. I don't know. It has a nice Jordan red tag on it. I actually wanted red laces for these shoes, because I actually thought that was going to be fire. But none of my red laces that I actually have sitting around fit are like the correct length for the fours. All right, now we're on to fives. I only have one pair of fives. I don't know why I got these. To be honest, I worn these once. They are the What the Fives ketchup and mustard. I don't really like these at all. Like, I actually want to get rid of them because they're not doing nothing for my closet or anything like that. They had the reflective tags. I don't like these. Now we're on my Jordan 6s. I only have two pairs of 6s. The first ones, as you can tell by the little box, I have the DMPs. I love me all black 6s. I kept a little tag on here because I actually thought that was fire. I like the little dog tag it has. I don't really wear these as much anymore, but these are fire. Next, these are the Infrared Reds. These are my favorite 6s that I have because it's like the pop of, like, I don't know what you want to say, like a coral color, because it's not red or like pink. I honestly don't know. Next, I'm gonna do my Jordan 11s. I'm gonna start with my Jordan Lows. The shoes I'm about to show you are actually my first Jordans that I actually got in. Like, this was started it all, kind of. These are beat. I actually got these when I was like in eighth grade. These are the Jordan Cool Gray Low Tops. As you see, they are a little beat. You can tell by the bottom. They're not icy anymore, but. Next are my Citruses. I actually love these shoes a lot, but I don't wear them, as you can see, because at the bottom is actually so clean. Because these are like something you don't really wear often all the time, because it is an all white and orange Jordan Low. It's not really common. You don't really see this a lot. I don't really know what to pair it up with either. See, I'm building like my little Jordan wall behind me for my thumbnail. But I'm just now noticing, I think Jordan 11s are like the most Jordan style like number I have. Next I have, I don't really like these. I wore these once or twice. I got these back in like, I think 2018, 2019. They're like suede, like a really soft suede. They're not like your ordinary Jordan like 11. I got these because I thought they was gonna be hyped up. Next are the Jordan 11. I think these are Jubilees. I don't know, but the good catch. But these were more like the December releases. I think 2 years ago, if I'm not mistaken. These are fire. I actually like these a lot. They're just a regular black and silver shoe. You can wear these for literally anything. These are actually a throwback for me. Okay, I'm gonna take what I said earlier back. These are the shoes that I got in that actually made me start being a sneakerhead. Like, I got these in ninth grade. I remember, like, the Concourse came out, everybody wanted them, everybody got in them, and I was just like, ever since then, I actually started being on the Jordan wave. That's when I got the bread fours, the infrared sixes, and all that. And yeah, I actually beat these shoes up. All these shoes fall on me while I'm recording, I'm not posting the video. I'm like, if these shoes fall on me while I'm showing y'all the shoes, it's actually going to be tragic. And I'm actually be, I don't know. Anyway, next is the Jordan 11 Breads. These are my favorite 11s that I actually have. Cause these are actually fire. Like, what? Like, you cannot go wrong with the black. Like, you just can't go wrong. Like, these are my favorite 11s. These are my top three, maybe. Next, I think these are my favorite 11s. These are the cap and gown 11s. They're all black 11. You don't see these at all. Like, this is not a common shoe. I think that's why I like it a lot. These are fire. As you can see, I did wear these a lot because the sole was not as icy anymore. These are just fire. Like, get into it for real. Like, these are actually fire. And I have these. I don't wear these that much anymore. These are the all red Jordans. Yeah, as you see, I wore these a lot because the shoe is like gummy, like it's not icy anymore, it's like, you know. But I feel like that just gives the shoe a story to me. Right now we're on to the Jordan 12s. I'm actually surprised my phone hasn't stopped recording saying I lost storage, but I have these fire, feel me, just blue and black Jordan 12s. Simple, nothing crazy. I actually used to love 12s a lot, but I don't wear the 12s anymore because it's just like my style changes throughout the years. I just don't really wear Jordans anymore that much, to be honest. Next are the black and yellow Jordan 12s. I am a Steelers fan. I don't really follow football that much, but if you ask me what's my favorite team, I would say the Steelers, because that is the family's, like, my family, almost everyone is a Steelers fan, especially my dad. So I copped these. Me and my dad actually copped them just to rep. If we ever wear a Steelers jersey, or, you know, we just want to rep our colors, we would just... why me? I'm gonna still record, not gonna lie, because I only have just my 13 stuff to record, but like, are you serious? It kind of hit me in the back. Nice little back massage with the points, the corners of every box. Am I gonna pick it up again? Yeah. Did my ring light turn off? It did. It actually unplugged. Okay. After I got really interrupted by the boxes behind me, because they wanted to make an appearance, like they didn't just get shown off. Moving on to the 13s. The first shoe I'm about to show you is actually my favorite 13s I own. Because my other 13s are not a vibe anymore, but these, like, yeah, I just gave y'all ASMR. Like, do y'all not see the reflectiveness? These are actually insane. Like, these are actually fire. Like, these are the best 13s I own, and I'm getting loud because I'm actually passionate that I got these. I don't flip and wear them though, and that's insane, but I'm just so proud to say these are mine. Like, I'm their mommy. These are my babies. I actually forgot the name of these 13s, but it's something like got something game. I think these are actually expensive. I'm gonna look them up. Yeah, I'm gonna look up the little, like, the little SKU number, and I'm gonna tell y'all how much these like resell for. I have my handy dandy lappy toppy here. Oh, huh. Are these even those? I don't think they're worth nothing, actually. Let's go on Flight Club. It's called He Got Game. I knew what I was talking about. For a size 7, and those shoes is 313. I mean, I guess they kind of, let's see, size 10 men. It's 394. I'm gonna see what they go for my size. We're going on GOAT right now. So a size 5.5 in my shoe is 236. I mean, there is some profit you could get off of these shoes, because these go for 140. Nothing crazy, but thank you for joining the class of Jordan shoe mathematics and calculations. Next one I have are they're like the gray. I don't like these at all, honestly, if I'm being honest with you. I don't wear these at all. I got these back in 8th grade. Next 13 I have, I think these are the first 13s I've ever gotten. These were my babies back then. I had gotten these back in 8th grade. It came out in like the summer. I remember these were a summer release. First day of school, everybody had these on the feet, and I was one of them, because these was actually the shoes back then. Like, these was fire. They a little beat now, because I actually, like, they're not that bad. But they have some wear and tear on them. But these was the shoes back then. So yeah, guys, this is actually the end of my sneaker haul. These are all my shoes and cool kicks that I have. If this falls on me, I don't know what I'm gonna do with life. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I didn't include my Crocs. Should I include my Crocs? Because I just have mad Crocs, mad colorways, the regular schmegler degler, feel me? But I'm not doing Crocs. I have two pinks, two whites, blue, orange, tie-dye, and black. There you go. That's the Croc haul. You heard it from me. So yeah, guys, this is the end of the video now. Thank you guys so much for watching. It was actually fun recording this. Yeah, I have no words. Thank you for watching. If you made it this far, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I hope you have an amazing day. Yeah, I just did, we're back in class. This is sneaker mathematics and calculations. I just counted all my shoes, not including all my Croc colorways. I have 60 pairs of shoes. Huh? That's including Yeezy, UGG, Jordan, Converse, New Balances, and regular Nikes. 60 pairs of shoes is actually insane in the membrane. Because I always wondered how many shoes I had, like the exact amount, and it's 60 pairs, 60 plus, because I'm not including my Crocs that are down there chilling. So it's probably like around like 65, 70 pairs of actual shoe and footwear that I actually have to my name. Yeah, I just wanted to say that because it was like mind-boggling. I just wanted to share that because we're in class right now. So yeah, this is actually the end of the video now. Okay. So thank you for watching. If you made it this far, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.